11:15 p.m., just 45 minutes from the bright new year of 1958. To make what's left of this year and all of next year bright for you, Clairol, the first name in hair color, in behalf of the hairdressers of America, presents... Guy Lombardo and his Royal Canadians, direct from the world-famous grill room of the Roosevelt Hotel at 45th Street and Madison Avenue here in New York City. And now, here is Mr. New Year's Eve himself, Guy Lombardo.
Thank you, George Brian, and ladies and gentlemen, it's certainly wonderful having you all here to help celebrate New Year's Eve at the Roosevelt Grill. Now, we're going to, in this next hour, we're going to play songs, great songs of the past New Year's Eves. We're going to play the great songs of 1957. We're going to keep you posted on the time, and every once in a while, we're going to take you over to Times Square to see what's going on over there. As a matter of fact, at 11:55, we're going over there for 5 minutes to see New Year's Eve come in at Times Square, then back here for more music and more singing. Now, we're going to start with a great New Year's Eve song of the early 30s. And by the way, in the early 30s, that was the era when Clairol, the first name in hair color, started in business. A great song of that era was Top Hat, White Tie, and Tails. You know, in 1934, some of the big hits were, I Get a Kick Out of You, The Last Roundup, St. James Infirmary. And that year, a great New Year's Eve tune that everyone danced to right here in the Roosevelt Grill was The Continental.
Only 6 minutes to midnight.
Over to Times Square and see what's going on over there. With the stroke of midnight, when you see 12 o'clock, you're going to hear our Auld Lang Syne played from the Roosevelt Grill. Then we'll be back here in the grill room to wish you a very happy new year and more music and more dancing. And now to Robert Trout at Times Square.
Times Square. This is Times Square as the great moment approaches. The heart of the nation's largest city preparing to go mad at midnight. A tumultuous farewell to the year 1957 and a noisier welcome to the unknown year 1958. From this balcony on the front of the Sheraton Astor Hotel in Times Square, this is how the New York Times building looks. That's the center of all attention, or it shortly will be. The ball of lights on top of the 70-foot flagpole. The flagpole itself, 27 stories above the street level. 20 seconds before midnight, you know, that ball of lights will start to come down slowly, slowly. And when it hits the roof, you will really hear an uproar. I don't know how it sounds to you now, but how these people have been making all this noise for more than an hour and are still going strong, it's pretty hard to tell. There's so many of them down there that we can't even find the police commissioner to have him tell us how many he thinks there are. It looks as if there are at least 500,000, though. 500,000 shouting, yelling, blowing whistles and horns, every conceivable kind of horn. Guitars, balloons, umbrellas. It started to rain about 11:15, but that hasn't seemed to make any difference at all. They jump. They wave like a field of grain when the mountain wind hits it. An enormous field. 40th Street to 53rd, blocked off. Here in Broadway, Times Square. The pigeons don't like it. Every December 31st, the pigeons fly away somewhere else, unhappily. All of them looking up at us now, at this balcony, on the Sheraton Astor Hotel. Swiss scientists tell us this year It won't be 1958 until 3/1000ths of a second after midnight, so all gentlemen who are planning to kiss ladies might keep that in mind. It won't be officially the next year until 3/1000ths of a second past midnight. But they're just warming up for the magic moment, the great moment of midnight. Here's the largest electric sign in the world, a block and a quarter long, and that waterfall has 8,000 gallons of antifreeze in it for winter. Scraps of paper falling down through the air. People throwing homemade confetti. And now everyone, as if by signal, turns and faces south. Faces go up, looking up at the Times building. It may not be time, but they seem to sense that it is, almost. One lone sign down there, judgment coming, seek ye the Lord. But it's lost almost in the crowd. Up now to the ball of lights. It doesn't look as if it started to move yet. The New York Times electrician consults his watch, you know. And at 20 seconds before midnight, he pushes the button. And there it comes, slowly descending. Listen to the roar now. The magic moment. It is 1958. A new year is born. The globe of light seemed to go out just before it touched the roof. And those letters, 1958, those figures came on slightly before the globe had touched the roof. But it's official. The new year is here. And those numbers are blazing forth on all four sides of the New York Times building. The building here in Times Square. Has died, and the great annual blessed event has happened. A new year has been born. Firecrackers exploding in the crowd now, but they don't care. A very happy scene as well as a tumultuous one. So now it's time for us to say it's Happy New Year in Times Square, and so back to the dance.
Everybody, a very happy new year, especially from all of us, and especially from Claro, the first name in hair color. We hope you have a wonderfully happy and prosperous 1958. Happy New Year! And now let's start this new year of 1958 with a sing-song. You all know the lyrics to this, even you folks at home. I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad.
Holiday time's a good time for the good taste of Coke. the holidays coming. Let's have fun, bring Coca-Cola for everyone. Holiday time's a good time for the good taste of Coke.
Enjoy ice-cold Coca-Cola, sign of good taste.
The following program is Your Hit Parade, as originally telecast Saturday, December 31st, 1955.
Richard Hudnut, makers of Quick, the new home permanent with a 10-minute waving lotion, in co-sponsorship with Lucky Strike, the cigarette that tastes better, cleaner, fresher, smoother, presents Your Hit Parade.
Quick, quick, Richard Hudnut, new home permanent. Quick, quick, can be done in just 1 hour. From start to savvy, get Richard Hudnut, new home permanent, and get it quick.
Tonight, Richard Hudnut presents Your Hit Parade. The top tunes all over America, as determined by Your Hit Parade survey, which checks the best sellers in sheet music and phonograph records. The songs most heard on the air, and the songs most played on the automatic coin machine. An accurate, authentic tabulation of America's taste in popular music. Your Hit Parade.
Listen, please listen to the story of Quick, the Richard Hudnut new home permanent. Quick, lanolin's there to give your hair that healthy shine. Protect your hair from damage, help prevent that dry, dull, lifeless look. Can be done in just 1 hour. From start to steady, get Richard Hudnut new home permanent. Quick, get it quick.
And now, the top seven songs of the week with Dorothy Collins, Snooky Lanson, Giselle McKenzie, Russell Arnes, the Hit Paraders and Dancers, and Raymond Scott and the Hit Parade Orchestra. And off we go with survey song number two. Russell Arnes and your Hit Parade cast bring a New Year's Eve greeting to the tune of Memories Are Made of This.
Sweet, sweet memories you gave of me. You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Take one fresh and tender kiss.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Add a stolen night of bliss.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
One girl, one boy, some grief, some joy. Memories are made of this. Don't forget a small moonbeam. Fold in gently in a dream.
The memories you gave for me.
Your lips and mine. Two sips of wine. Memories are made of this.
The memories you gave for me.
Then add the wedding bells. One house where lovers dwell. Three little kids for the flavor.
Stir carefully through the days.
How the flavor stays. These are the things you will savor. With his blessings from above.
The memories you gave for me.
Serve it generously with love.
The memories you gave for me.
One man, one wife, one love through life. Memories are made of this.
The memories you gave for me.
Memories are made of this.
Happy New Year!
Survey song number six.
It's Hail and Farewell to Christmas, as Dorothy Collins sings that perennial holiday favorite, White Christmas.
The treetops listen, and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Richard Hudnut Extra. The Hit Parade dancers join Raymond Scott for a New Year's Eve fantasy with the tune of There'll Be a Hot Time in the Old Town Tonight. Year's Eve in Paris finds Giselle McKenzie singing the original French version of Survey Song Number 3, Autumn Leaves.
C'est une chanson qui nous ressemble, toi qui m'aimais, moi qui t'aimais, nous vivions tous les deux ensemble, toi qui m'aimais.
Now let's go backstage at your hit parade and join Julia Mead.
Hello. Tonight I have news you've wanted to hear for a long time. Now there's a home permanent that looks and lasts much more like naturally curly hair. It's new Improved Quick by Richard Hudnut. The only home permanent with an exclusive Richard Hudnut penetrating ingredient that prevents weak surface waves. Now, this is what can happen with an ordinary home permanent. See how weak and limp the wave is? It's just on the surface. And here's a new Improved Quick Curl. The penetrating ingredient has gone into every hair and waved it gently, evenly, and lastingly. You'll have a soft wave that's much more like naturally curly hair and lasts at least 6 months. And new Double Analyzed Quick is still the quickest, just 1 hour from start to setting. You've always wanted a wave that's much more like naturally curly hair. Well, Quick, with the new penetrating ingredient, is it. And only famous Richard Hudnut makes it. So get it, Quick, won't you?
Number 7 on the survey. Snooky Lanson is a musical father time as he brings us a tuneful tribute to love and marriage.
Carriage, this I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, it's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary. Try to separate them, it's an illusion. Try, and you will only come to this conclusion. Love and marriage go together like a horse and carriage. Dad was told by mother, you can't have one, you can't have none, you can't have one without the other. Them, it's an illusion. Try, and you will only come to this conclusion. Love and marriage go together like a horse and carriage. Dad was told by mother,
Dorothy Collins finds a timeless message of faith in survey song number 4, He.
I forgive.
He can turn the tides and calm the angry sea. Every star that makes our darkness bright, He keeps watch all through the long and lonely night. He still finds the time to hear a child's first prayer, saint or sinner.
Song number 5. It's New Year's Day in the morning as Russell Arm sings Moments to Remember.
The day we tore the goalpost down, we will have these moments to remember. The quiet walks, the noisy fun, the ballroom prize we almost won. We will have these moments to remember. Summer turns to winter, and the present disappears. The laughter we were glad to share will echo through the years. When other nights and other days may find us gone our separate ways, we will have these moments to remember. We will have these moments to remember.
Another Richard Hudnut Extra. Giselle McKenzie, the hit paraders and dancers are resolved that in 1956 we must all rise and shine.
Rise and shine, stand up and take it. Rise and shine, life's what you make it. If Luna so and so should get you, as he soon does,
just like the moon does. Rise and shine.
Don't be a mourner.
Things are fine.
Around the corner. No harm in trying it. There's nothing to it. You can do it. Like the sun, rise and shine.
Rise and shine. Get up. It's the early morning.
Be a little sunbeam.
Up and get up. Rise and shine.
Co-sponsor, Lucky Strike.
Light up, Lucky.
It's light up time.
Be happy, go lucky.
It's light up time.
For the taste that you like, light up a Lucky Strike.
Relax.
It's light up time.
Why is it when folks are stepping out, you so often see Lucky's going along? It's just that Lucky's always taste better. That's because they're made of fine tobacco. Naturally mild, good-tasting tobacco that's toasted. That's right, it's toasted to taste even better. Cleaner, fresher, smoother. Next time you're going out, take a pack of Lucky's along with you. You'll say they're the best-tasting cigarette you ever smoked.
For the taste that you like, light up a lucky strike.
Right now.
Light up a lucky.
It's light up time.
Number one, the top tune of the week. The song the survey finds in first place. Snooky Lanson steps into the winner spotlight with song number one, 16 Tons.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood, skin and bones. Mind that's weak and the back that's strong. You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. Loaded 16 tons a number 9 coal. And the straw boss said, well, bless my soul. 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Coming better, step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Is presented each week co-sponsored by Richard Hutnut and Lucky Strike. So tune in again next week at the same time for the top seven songs of the week. This is Andre Baruch saying, save time, get quick, by Richard Hutnut.
This is an egg, and I'm Julia Mead, and nothing puts that magic sheen in your hair like an old-fashioned egg shampoo, except Richard Hutnut Enriched Cream Shampoo. With real eggs powdered into the golden lotion to give all the magic sheen of an old-fashioned shampoo the easy way. See the clean and beautiful sheen on Louise's hair. You'll have it too with Richard Hutnut shampoo. And to seal in that sheen, use this perfect shampoo finish, Richard Hutnut Cream Rinse.
The preceding program was Your Hit Parade as originally telecast Saturday, December 31st, 1955.
Homemade macaroni and cheese makes a hit. And it's simple with Kraft macaroni and cheese dinner. Only a nickel a serving, too. you get tender macaroni and new improved Kraft grated that makes Kraft dinner golden with rich cheddar flavor. For this tasty main dish, we've spooned into it are the frankfurters that we've split and broiled and then spread with mustard. The garnish is pimento. Enjoy it often. Kraft macaroni and cheese dinner. And to get any of tonight's recipes free, send a postcard with your name and address to Kraft Television Recipes, Box 1718, Chicago 77, Illinois.
This is it. The dynamic new DeSoto for 1958. The look and feel of the future. The new DeSoto has a new look, a new engine, and a new ride. Part of that new look is a new windshield that curves back into the roof to give you the best visibility in history.
The car for you in 58 has style and beauty to captivate. It's delightful, it's lovely, it's DeSoto.
Hello, I'm John Cameron Swayze. These letters are from men, and these from the ladies. From small towns and big cities. Some of these people are young, some not so young, but they all have one thing in common. They're looking for a chance for romance. You'll meet many of these interesting people on our Monday through Friday daytime show here on ABC. A staff of psychologists and marriage counselors carefully selects each guest and the three men or women whom they meet on the program. As they come to know each other, well, who knows? A long and lasting friendship may develop. Join us here every weekday afternoon for human interest dramas as real as life itself. Look in as plain people have their chance for romance on the ABC television network.
Friendships made every afternoon at 2 over most of these stations.
Imperial. Now, Imperial combines the best of both table spreads. Yes, Imperial, the great new super spread, combines the best qualities of margarine, easy spreadability, consistent quality, and the best qualities of nature's own spread. Natural taste, natural aroma. Now you can enjoy the best of both, the best of the two table spreads, combined in one great new super spread, Imperial.
I used to use two different kinds of spreads, one for the table, the other for the kitchen. But now I use Imperial exclusively, because Imperial gives me the best of both.
Yes, there's no other spread like Imperial, because Imperial gives you the best of margarine and the best of nature's own spread combined in one new super spread. To protect Imperial's fine ingredients, always keep it refrigerated.
Cadillac's newest marvel of styling and engineering is now at your Cadillac dealers. The 1958 Cadillac is brilliantly new in beauty, with fabrics and appointments that introduce a new concept of interior elegance. And Cadillac's dynamic 1958 engine and revolutionary air suspension provide a totally new experience in modern motoring. See and drive motordom's masterpiece, the 1958 Cadillac.
The holiday season, when peace and goodwill fill the air, the American Broadcasting Company Television Network joins its family of stations and stars in extending to you and your family our very best wishes for a happy holiday and a bright new year.
Thank you.
season's greetings from ABC.
From Hollywood, the ABC Television Network presents Dr. IQ, the Mental Banker.
I have a lady doctor. I have a gentleman doctor.
And I have silver dollars for your correct answers.
And here he is, the wise man with a friendly smile, Dr. IQ.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, everyone. We greet you from ABC Television Center in Hollywood. Our program is entirely unrehearsed. We suggest you people at home play right along with our studio contestants to see how many silver dollars you could win. Out in the audience are my two lovely assistants with their portable microphones. I'd like you to meet them right now. On my left, Miss Sue England.
Thank you, Doctor.
And on my right, Miss Carol Byron.
Thank you, Doctor.
I'd like to remind you that sometime during our program tonight, you will hear this signal. Listen. Now, when you hear that signal, whoever I'm talking to at the time will have the opportunity of spinning the wisdom wheel and winning up to $100 in cash. Let's begin our program this evening as we go first to my left and Miss Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Mary Ann Garver from Honolulu, Hawaii.
All right, Mary Ann. You know, friend of the children and scourge of the rats was the famous Pied Piper. For eight silver dollars, what town did the Pied Piper rid of rats? Eglin, Baconland, or Hamlin?
England.
England? Your choices are Eglin.
Eglin,
is that your choice? I'm very sorry. It happens to be Hamlin. But we have for you a souvenir Dr. IQ silver dollar. Thank you very much for being with us. Over now to Carol Byron.
I have a gentleman doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir.
Leonard Rosenthal, Chicago, Illinois.
All right, Leonard, for 10 silver dollars, for what word is ABBR, the abbreviation?
Abbreviation.
Yes, sir, that's right. For what is it the abbreviation? Oh, you mean that's your answer?
Yes, sir.
You're right, for 10 silver dollars, absolutely. Don't let me talk you out of those right answers. Let's go over now to Sue England.
I have a gentleman doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
Eugene Pucci of Rochester, New York.
Happy to have you with us, Mr. Pucci. This is for 15 silver dollars. President Eisenhower celebrated his birthday on October 14th. Now, within one candle, if you, Mr. Pucci, had baked a birthday cake for President Eisenhower, how many candles would you have put on his cake this year?
68.
You're right on the nose for 15 silver dollars. Yes, sir. 68 years of age, our president. Let's go over now to Carol Byron on the right.
I have a lady doctor.
What is your name and your hometown, please?
Mrs. Audrey McClinic, Maslin, Ohio.
From Ohio, Maslin, Ohio. This is for 7 silver dollars. If you were to call kitty, 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 the animal most likely to respond would say meow. Now, you imitate the animal that would most logically respond to the call of suey, suey, suey.
A pig.
You imitate the animal. I don't want to hear the name. What is it?
Oi, 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 oi.
That's worth 7 silver dollars. Now let's go over to my right and Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
What is your name and your hometown, please?
Evelyn Dyer, Washington, D.C.
Happy to have you with us, Evelyn. This is for 11 silver dollars. You know, their eyelashes give camels the most glamorous eyes in the animal kingdom. Now, why do camels have such long eyelashes? So their eyes won't get strained too much by the desert sun? So they won't get too much sand in their eyes? Or so they will look attractive to other camels?
I'll try to keep the sand out of their eyes.
You're going
to
try that? That's worth 11 silver dollars. That's the right answer. Let's go now to Carol Byron on the right.
I have a gentleman doctor.
What is your name and your hometown, sir?
John Farrell from London, England.
From London, England.
That's
We're
right.
very happy to have you, John.
Thank you.
This is for 6 silver dollars to take back to London. The famous words, out, damn spot, out, I say, were written by the owner of the first cleaning and pressing shop in America, yes or no?
Definitely no.
You're definitely right for 6 silver dollars. Those are the words, of course, of Mr. Shakespeare. Back to the back row in Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Mrs. D. Turner, Hollywood, California.
From Hollywood. All right, this is for 18 silver dollars, ma'am. If an uncle died and left you a lazy strap, a blind, crupper, belly band, hames, check grain, throat latch, winker stay, bag swivel, and crown piece, What would you have to buy in order to make use of them?
A horse.
You say a horse, you're right, for 18 silver dollars. We got a mighty sharp audience tonight, and now let's go over to Carol Byron.
I have a very young gentleman, Doctor.
How do you do, sir? What is your name in your hometown?
Larry Osborne of Burbank.
Your name is Larry Osborne, and you have kind of red hair, isn't it, Larry?
Yeah, I guess so.
All right, Larry, let's see what we have for a question for you. Let's go back to the flapper era. I don't think you could go back that far, so I'm going to ask you this one. By logical reasoning, you can figure this one out, Larry. In the story of Alibaba and the 40 Thieves, the words open sesame were said to make a door open. Now, for 20 silver dollars, what words were said to make the door close? You can figure this one out by logical reasoning, you know.
Shut.
You say shut? Well, I tell you what. On my card, it says closed sesame, but I think you could get them closed with shut, so I'm going to give you 20 silver dollars, Larry. Thank you very much for being with us. Let's go over now to my left and Miss Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Mrs. Zelda Roth from Van Nuys, California.
Your last name is what?
Roth.
Mrs. Roth?
Yes.
Mrs. Roth, would you please stand by, for in just one moment, I would like to ask you our famous quotation question.
Every day, Monday through Friday, exciting courtroom drama is yours for the viewing on most of these ABC television stations on Day in Court. You'll eavesdrop on criminal and civil cases presided over by Judge Edgar Allen Jones, Jr., as both accused and accuser are heard telling their fascinating stories on the witness stand. Based on actual court cases, the cases you witness reveal the conflicts and absorbing personal stories which unfold each day on our courts. Sharing the bench with Judge Jones on Day in Court is Judge William Gwynn, who hears domestic relations and juvenile matters. Judge Gwynn's decisions deeply affect the lives of the families, parents, and young people who come before him, providing you with compelling television viewing. You'll see Day in Court at a new time, 2 p.m. every weekday, starting this coming Monday on the ABC Television Network. That's Day in Court, Monday through Friday at 2 on ABC.
Once more, we come to that gem of wisdom, our famous quotation question. We have Mrs. Roth standing by. Mrs. Roth, if you have the correct answer to our famous quotation, you are going to win 25 silver dollars. If, however, you do not answer it correctly, the same quotation next week will be worth 50 silver dollars. So, Mrs. Roth, are you ready for our famous quotation?
Yes.
All right, here it is. What famous man said, "In any event, I shall do my best. I shall keep the soldier's faith." No coaching on this, please. 5 seconds, Mrs. Roth. For 25 silver dollars, what is your answer, please?
President Eisenhower.
I am very sorry, ma'am. That is not the correct answer. That means the next week, this same quotation will be worth 50 silver dollars. But, Sue, give that lady a Dr. IQ souvenir silver dollar along with our compliments. Thank you, ma'am. Over now to Carol Byron.
I have a lady, doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Dorothy Seltzer from Cortland, New York.
Dorothy Seltzer from Cortland, New York. Dorothy, once more, we come to that little monument to memory, the Thought Twister, which I will say one time and one time only. If you can repeat it after me exactly as I say it, I will give you 35 silver dollars. Are you ready for the Thought Twister?
Yes, I am.
All right, listen to this.
Never.
All right. Lily is chilly, said Willie to Billy. Lily is chilly, Willie. To him, said Billy. Would you repeat that, please?
Lily is chilly, said Willie to Billy. Billy is... Billy is chilly to...
It's getting kind
Willie
of cool all over, isn't
to
it?
To him,
John?
Said Willie.
It's that time of year, but I'm sorry, the last line you did not have correct. It should read, Lily is chilly, said Willie to Billy. Lily is chilly, Willie to him, said Billy. See how easy it really is. Give that lady a Dr. IQ silver dollar. Thank you, ma'am. Let's go over now to Sue England on my left.
I have a lady, doctor.
What is your name and your hometown, please?
Pauline says Manchester, England.
From Manchester, England, this is your lucky evening. You hear that signal? That means that this is your opportunity to spin our wisdom wheel and win up to 100 silver dollars. As Sue England brings you down, I'll explain to you just how it works. You see, you can win any amount. Come right up here, if you will. What is your name once again?
Pauline says.
Pauline what?
Sayers.
Pauline Sayers. Pauline, you can win anywhere from $1 all the way up to $100, and of course all these numbers in between represent silver dollars. You just simply spin this wheel, and wherever it stops, let's say it stops there, there's a card above it, and if you can answer that question, you've got five silver dollars or wherever it might end up. Now, that's pretty simple, isn't it?
Yes.
Could you use, say, $100?
Huh? Oh, sure could.
You're from where? Manchester, England?
Yes.
What are you doing over here?
I'm working.
Oh, you're working? You're here for good, then, huh? Well, let's see if you can give this wheel a spin, and good luck to you. Give it a good spin, and then that's it. Now, step right back, and let's take a watch. Just keep your eye on it. We'll keep our fingers crossed, huh? What do you think you want to go for, 100 or 50 or what? You know, the more money, the more difficult the question. Huh? 100? Oh, it's up to 100. 1, 25, 20. It's going to stop on five silver dollars, so here is your slot. For five silver dollars, the question shouldn't be too rough. So, now I am thinking of something you put on a salad. It is named for seven big islands and 1,600 little islands in the St. Lawrence River near Lake Ontario. It's a salad dressing. What would you ask for if you wanted to order it in a restaurant for five silver dollars?
Island dressing.
Is that all?
For salad.
What is that?
Island dressing for salad.
Island dressing for salads on a dish over the napkin with a spoon. Is that? No, I mean, did anything before the salad, huh? You're trying to say a 1,000 island salad dressing?
Yes.
That's right, for five silver dollars. Thank you very much for spinning the wisdom wheel. Let's go back now to Carol Byron in the audience.
I have a gentleman, doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
D.L. McClintock, Burbank.
Is that McClintock?
That's right.
All right, sir, from Burbank. Now, Mr. McClintock, Bobby Hammock, Bobby Hammock and the orchestra are going to play a few bars of a very familiar song for you. In fact, it's so familiar, it has three titles and three different sets of lyrics. Now, after Bobby plays a song for you, I will pay you five silver dollars for each of the titles you can name and 20 silver dollars if you can name all three. Listen. Now, Mr. McClintock, what are the three titles by which this song is known? Name as many as you can think of.
He's a Jolly Good Fellow.
For one. Is that all you can come up with, sir?
I won't get home until...
What is that?
I won't get home till morning.
That's number two. I'll give you 5 seconds to think of that third one. No coaching, please. Sorry, sir, the time is up. The third one is The Bear Went Over the Mountain. But you had two right. That earns for you 10 silver dollars. Congratulations to you, sir. Let's go over now to Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown?
Gil Gulf, Los Angeles, California.
Gil, what is your last name?
Gullo.
Gullo?
Yes.
And how old are you, Gil?
14 and a half.
You're 14 and one half. All right, Gil. This is for 10 silver dollars. Which of these would you most logically measure in a tablespoon? Uranium, sugar, or tables?
Sugar.
You're right, for 10 silver dollars. Sugar is the right answer. And now let's go over to... Uh-oh. You hear that music? Time now for our phone question. Our operators have just placed a call to one of you lucky people. And here is Carol Byron to tell us who we're talking to tonight.
Doctor, for our first telephone call, we've gone clear across the nation to Manchester, New Hampshire, 2,796 miles away, to a man who is a great Dr. IQ fan.
Well, happy to hear that. It's
Mr. Fred Lesniak.
Fred Lesniak. Hello there, Mr. Lesniak.
Hello.
Can you hear me pretty good, sir?
Yes, I can.
Well, it's our pleasure to be talking to you. How are you this evening?
Pretty good. You?
Just fine, thank you, sir. Are you a family man up there in Manchester, New Hampshire?
Yes, I am, sir.
Tell me something about your family, children, and what have you. Do you have children, sir?
Yes, one boy, 2.5 years old.
One boy?
Right.
Well, sir, we're very happy to be talking to you this evening, Mr. Lesniak. And I tell you what, I have a question here which is worth 25 silver dollars. This close to Christmas, could you by any chance use 25 silver dollars?
Sure,
you could. All right, Mr. Lesniak, good luck to you on this question. Are you ready for it?
Yes, I am.
Here it is. Before Queen Elizabeth was crowned, what was the name of the Crown Princess of Great Britain? For 25 silver dollars.
The Crown Princess?
Yes, sir. Let me repeat the question. Before Queen Elizabeth was crowned, what was the name of the Crown Princess of Great Britain? 5 seconds, sir.
Your answer, sir?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid I don't know.
Oh, I'm very sorry as well. It was Elizabeth. Before she was queen, she quite naturally was the crown princess. But, sir, let me see. I just happen to notice here you're watching our program on WMUR-TV. Isn't that right?
That's right, sir.
Well, I want to thank you very much, sir, for sending in your card. And even though you did not have the correct answer, look what we do have for you. Carol is coming in here with a beautiful Dr. IQ silver dollar key ring, which we're going to send to you, Mr. Lesniak, with our compliments. Thank you very much for calling in, and a very Merry Christmas to you and your family.
Thank you.
All right, sir. Goodbye.
I know.
There's Mr. Fred Lesniak from Manchester, New Hampshire. If you people at home would like to be called anywhere in the United States, if you answer the question correctly, next week, incidentally, this question or another question will be worth 50 silver dollars. If you'd like to be the one called at home, all you have to do is send a postcard with your name, address, and phone number to Dr. IQ, ABC TV, Hollywood 27, California. Your card may be the one selected, and then you can play our game for cash for correct answers. We'll be placing another home call next week. Just one moment, we come to that famous part of our program where I talk next to the lady in the balcony.
This is my song.
Hi, folks. We're hard at work getting ready for our show. It takes a lot of people to put a show like this together. The cameraman has to keep on his toes because things move pretty fast. Oh, we have lots of surprises with wonderful guest stars dropping in every week. The mic man's going to be mighty important, too, on our show, because you'll be hearing your favorite songs, old and new. Oh, and say, about the sets. Right on the job. We have lots of exciting sets. Well, I think we're about ready. Quiet, everyone. Okay, Patty, take it away. Hello, I'm Patty Page. Hello, I'm Patty Page. Oh, and don't forget this dial, because here's where we'll be with a half hour of music, comedy, and wonderful easy fun every week on ABC.
I have a lady in the balcony, Doctor. Here for her first week from St. Louis, Missouri. She gave up an opera career to become the mother of 9 children, Mrs. Lorraine Gerard. Good
night. Well, hello there, Mrs. Gerard.
Hello, Dr.
May I welcome you as our very first lady in the balcony?
Thank you.
We couldn't find a prettier lady for our first one, I'll tell you that.
Well, thank you very much.
Is it true that you have 9 children?
Well, you're approximately right.
What do you mean?
I have 9 and 5 nights.
Really? Well, congratulations
Thank
to you.
You.
What are the 9 children? Boys, girls, or what?
I have 6 boys and 3 girls.
Isn't that wonderful? Mm-hmm. How do they range in age?
Let me see. I have 2 at 11, 9, 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, and 1.
What do you mean you have 2 at 11? Did you have twins?
My first were twins, yes.
Oh, boy. You've had quite a full life. I imagine they keep you kind of
busy,
don't
they? They keep me hopping. They keep me on my toes.
And now, how about this opera career that... Sue told us about. Tell us something about that.
It was in its minor stages, but it was lots of fun. I was with the St. Louis Grand Opera Company, and then I appeared with the Gran Compañía Internacional de Cuba, which sounds very high-sounding.
It
I know.
Sure does.
And
boy,
it was lots of fun.
Well, I guess you know a lot about opera then, huh?
I have a great love for it.
Well, I have news for you. We don't have one question for you about opera tonight. Not a single
That's
one.
That's just my luck, isn't it?
Well, listen, I want to tell you now, as our lady in the balcony, Mrs. Gerard, you have agreed to come back every week for 4 weeks or until you miss your 5th question. Each night I will ask you 5 questions. Whenever you miss a question, I will turn off, if these are on, yeah, you see these lights are on, and then every time you miss a question, I turn off one light like this. Now, if you can go 4 weeks without having your 5th light turned off, you will receive all of the money in your jackpot as well as the money in the 4 weeks jackpot, which we're starting off, incidentally, with 100 silver dollars. Now, if you do not complete the 4 weeks, you will receive only half the money in your personal jackpot. The other half will go into the 4 weeks jackpot. Are you ready?
As ready as I will ever be.
All right. Let's hope I don't turn off any of those lights.
Let's hope not.
Let's get to work on that jackpot of yours. Right. Here's your first question. A fine actor who climbed to fame in the Broadway production of The King and I has a first name that sounds like the old English word for Christmas. 9 silver dollars is yours if you can tell me his name.
His name is Yul Brynner.
You're right for 9 silver dollars, and you're starting off very well, Mrs. Gerard. Of all the many men who have been king of England, only one monarch has willingly given up his throne. 15 silver dollars is yours if you can tell me his name and number.
I think it was Edward VII. I may be 6th.
Oh, you should have gone the other way. I'm eight. Very sorry. You had to have the name and number. It was Edward the Eighth. But there goes number five light. You have four more to go.
Alrighty.
Here is question number three. One of the most famous of all Christmas stories is The Gift of the Magi by O. Henry. Mm-hmm. It's the story of a girl who sold her beautiful long hair in order to buy a Christmas present for her husband. You're familiar with it, aren't
yes.
you? All right. I will give you 17 silver dollars if you can tell me what gift her husband bought her for Christmas.
She sold her hair for a watch.
Yes.
And he sold his watch to buy her, oh, dear, something for her hair.
And what would that be?
Barrette? No. Oh, I can't think of it.
You're so close, and I'm sorry.
Coronet.
No, ma'am, it's a comb.
Comb, all that.
And I
right.
just couldn't give you a hint. I'm very sorry.
Know,
I hate to turn
know.
Out that light because you were close, but let's see how well you do on the fourth question. $10 silver will be your reward if you can unscramble the two well-known proverbs that I am going to mix up for you. Now, here goes. Let dogs waste haste, make sleeping lie.
Let sleeping dogs lie,
and
haste makes waste.
You're right for $10 silver. Your jackpot is now up to $19 silver. Here's your fifth and final question for $7 silver. In Dickens' famous Christmas Carol, what was the family name of Tiny Tim? Cratchit, Scratchit, or Matchit?
Cratchit.
You're right for $7 silver. Mrs. Gerard, on your first evening, you built your jackpot to $26 silver. The four-week jackpot is still at 100, so we'll see you next week at the same time. You'll be with us then?
I'll be delighted.
We'll certainly be looking forward to seeing you. Thank you very much,
Thank
Mrs.
You.
Gerard. Thank you,
Good
ma'am.
Night.
I hope you ladies... Hope you ladies at home have been keeping your score, and if you have scored as well or even better than our lady in the balcony, why don't you let us know about it? Give us a bit of your background, if you will, please, and send us a card. Just drop that card to Dr. IQ, KABC-TV, Hollywood 27, California. You may be a very logical candidate for Our Lady in the Balcony. Let's go back now to our audience and Carol Byron.
I have a gentleman, Doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
Cecil Moore, Griffin, Georgia.
How do you do, Mr. Moore? This is for $12 silver. Within 5 years, how long did it take Daniel Webster to compile the dictionary? 5 seconds, sir.
7 years.
Oh, I'm very sorry, sir. It took Noah Webster 21 years to do it. But we're going to give you a Dr. IQ souvenir silver dollar. Thank you, sir. Over now to Sue England, way back in the back.
I have a gentleman, Doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
Max Korn, Miami Beach, Florida.
All right, Max. It's time now for one of Dr. IQ's most popular features, the biographical portrait, in which I describe a famous person a clue at a time. If you can correctly identify the personality I am describing after the clue is given, I will give you $75 silver. The longer it takes you to identify the personality, the less your reward. Are you ready for the first clue?
Yes.
All right, sir. I'd like to remind you, you may make a guess after each clue without penalty. Here's your first clue for $75 silver. He was born on November 4th, 1879, in a place called Ulaga, Oklahoma. All right, second clue for $60 silver. At the age of 17, he went to Argentina, where he made $4 a month punching cattle. From there, he went to South Africa and got a job breaking horses for the British during the Boer War.
No.
All right, for number three, $50 silver. At the close of the war, he joined a Wild West show, billing himself as the Cherokee Kid. No luck. Here's your fourth clue for $35 silver. Back in the United States, his first real fame came as a vaudeville performer, combining rope twirling with humorous comment. No coaching, please. $35 silver.
See, he was the one that went that showed me the airplane.
I have to know his name, sir. I'm sorry, I have to go to the next clue. This is for $25 silver. Later, he became well known as a newspaper columnist, a radio star, and a motion picture star. Concentrate. Here is your sixth clue for $15 silver. He expressed his philosophy of life when he said, I joke about every prominent man of my time, but I never met a man I didn't like. I wish I could tell you. Here is the seventh clue for $10 silver. He lost his life, as you said, in an airplane crash near Point Barrow, Alaska, on a flight with Wiley Post. Does Wiley Post help to bring it back?
No, I don't remember the name.
Here's your eighth clue for $5 silver. He was known as the Sage of Claremore, Oklahoma. Here's your last clue for $1 silver. His first two names were William Penn, but he was called Will...
Rogers.
That's right for $1 silver. Let's go over now to Carol Byron.
I have a young lady, doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Ann Gorgeous of Burbank.
All right, Ann, for 10 silver dollars, what does the M stand for in the name of Vice President Richard M. Nixon? Mill Stream, Mill House, or Mill Town? 5 seconds.
Mill House.
You say Mill House? That's right, for 10 silver dollars. Yes, ma'am. Richard Mill House Nixon. That signal, ladies and gentlemen, means it's time now for our winner's circle question. My assistants have given each of tonight's winners a card. I want you people to write on that card your name, the amount of money you won, and the answer to the question I'm about to give you. To the person who comes closest to the correct answer, I will double his or her money. Listen to this question. When Elvis Presley was drafted as a $78 a month rookie in the Army, how much money did his manager say it would cost the government in income tax each year? As you're giving us the answer to that question and coming down to our winner's circle, here is something of interest to everyone.
Hi there, this is Peter Lind Hayes.
And this is Mary Healy.
We're inviting you to join us on our show. First of all, we thought we might do something dramatic, then we decided against it because there are so many successful
ones. Oh, John! John, how could you do this to me, John? Oh, John! After all that we meant to each other, oh, John, 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 John!
What is this, my wife's other John? Anyway, if you're available, I hope you will join us. The format's going to be rather...
Oh, John! John, it's not true what they say about me, John. It's not true. I'm not a bad woman, John. Tell me I'm not bad. Tell me I'm not bad. Tell me I'm not bad.
You're not very good either. Actually, the format of the...
Oh, John! John, don't look at me that way, John.
You mean there's another way?
John, what are you going to do, John? What are you going to do?
I'm going to do a variety show called the Peter Lind Hayes Show on the ABC television network Monday through Friday. Be there.
Money doubled. As soon as we get a seat, sit down and make yourselves comfortable. The question is, when Elvis Presley went into the Army, a $78 a month rookie, how much is this going to cost the government in income taxes? Maybe the government isn't worried, but I'll bet his manager is. Well, you know the correct answer? It's $500,000. In income taxes. In just a moment, we're going to see who's going to get the money. We have this many ties? Look at this. Three different people. Oh, I see. They did not hit it on the nose, but three people said $1 million, and they came the closest. First one won $11. Evelyn Dyer from Washington. Well, who's Evelyn? Evelyn. All right, stand by. Eugene Pucci. All right, just a second, son. I'll get to you. Eugene Pucci from Los Angeles. Mr. Pucci is right here. Or no, pardon me. Over there. Don't hide. All right. And here is Leonard Rosenthal. Is that you? I'm sorry, son. Evidently, you didn't have a million. All three of you gentlemen are going to get your money doubled. Congratulations to you. Thank you very much. I'm afraid that's all the time we have tonight. We'll see you 1 week from now. Till then, I'd like to thank Carol and Sue and everyone who participated on the program. Tom Kennedy, your Dr. IQ, saying see you next week. Goodbye.
Dr. IQ, the Metal Banker, has been presented from ABC's Television Center in Hollywood. If you'd like to be called on the telephone at home and win silver dollars for correct answers, send a card to Dr. IQ, ABC TV, Hollywood 27. Once again, from Hollywood, we present Dr. IQ, the Metal Banker. This has been an ABC Television Network presentation. That American Bandstand man, Dick Clark, helps Patty Page introduce her two newest recordings. It's musical fun next over ABC Television Network.